Hi, I'm Marc Serota. I began my career in a time when Polaroid film was flourishing. Polaroid film was used as a barometer for how 35mm film was going to look when it came out of the camera. In my opinion, it was the original digital photography, way, way ahead of its time. And back then, Bill Clinton was the 42nd president of the United States. Gas was $1 a gallon. Stamps were 25 cents each. The Apple computer had a 100-megabyte hard drive and a 1.4 floppy disk. It was Linda McCartney, of all people, who taught me about image transfers and being creative with Polaroid film. I was a tour photographer for Paul, and she explained to me how a professional photographer was doing a campaign, whereas his assistant pulled the Polaroid prematurely, basically before the 60 seconds was up. And in order to keep all the goop and goo off of everything else, he just stuck that Polaroid straight down on a piece of paper. Later on, when he cleaned up the studio, he happened to pull the Polaroid off the piece of paper, leaving a partial transfer. It was something very creative, and thus Polaroid image transfer artwork was born. A lot of photographers do it in many different ways, but back in my day, it was a very unique process. It was used for album covers, for editorial layouts in fashion magazines, and for all sorts of commercial usages like annual reports. Hanging before you are several examples of some of my favorite image transfer artwork pieces. Here's how I created them. Step one, choosing the right image. Today I'm using the Polaroid image transfer machine as opposed to a Polaroid camera or back. For this, you need to select a slide or transparency, preferably one that's well lit and properly exposed. Step two, transferring your image. In order to transfer your image, insert your film here. Load your slide or transparency here. And select your exposure here. You then shoot your transfer and pull your Polaroid film prematurely. Then you set the wet or gooey side face down on a piece of paper, a piece of wood, a piece of cloth or fabric, or any surface you think will look good. You can roll it down with something flat like a rolling pin. Then you peel back the Polaroid and wait for it to dry down. Step three, use your tools. Once your transfer dries, you can then bring the artwork to life by using pastel pencils, charcoals, and even paints to create a one-of-a-kind piece of art.